started antiquity, like typical Indian, started buying foreign things, cut grass, this thing, that thing. And one day realized, I said, why am I buying foreign things? And the immense things available in India. There's immense things available in India. And I got in love with the company school, British artist. And then the guy used to sell me British art. He said, Vasai, why are you buying British art? And there's so many beautiful Indian art. And he sold me first to go in small painting metaphor. And since then, I've been trying to collect Indian art. My main passion has been water school from 1950 to 1960. Then Bombay, Baroda school. And I didn't really buy the air per se till 15 years ago. And that was also what my mother Teresa, who was my guru, not the same. I got my mother Teresa. It's just a thing. And my other passion is half of the art is lying around in people's houses, or junkyard, and shops to buy those paintings and get them destroyed so that they can be seen in front of the 100 people rather than be burned or sold. So half of the time I spend, while Smithy and other people spending time to catalog it properly, to get the painting destroyed, which is very hard work, very, very difficult. I've been buying things from Bombay also. And then my other passion is how to make average learned Indian go to museums to see art. The football is so poor. I mean, like, I have to give guidance to tell people where NGM was. Can you imagine? People did not know where NGM in Bombay was. Well, every time I come to Bombay, the first thing we do is come to NGM in Bombay. Anyway. We have a collection in Delhi, and we would have a show of Company School of Art and Hindi Art Fair. And my favorite artist is Janah show in our show. And every year we try to do 2, 3, 4 shows. And somebody asked me, what is the purpose of showing these works there? I said, these are things of chalaiye in private culture. Unless they're shown in public places, people will never see it. The whole purpose of making this effort, bringing all these paintings, photographs from Ghaziabad, from Noida to Bombay, at this expensive NGM with the building and my staff and their staff working, and displaying this painting, hopefully is that people will come and enjoy and see this and learn something. But photography is also art. People don't realize that photography is also art. Anyway, this is good.
Words of thanks, which I forgot.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, I'd love the NGMA staff to come here who have time in the show. Please, Aye.
She will do that.
Okay. The staff, besides the NGMA staff, who are terrific and wonderful to work with, it's always a pleasure when one is doing something creative to work with people who are themselves creative and support, and there was a lot of discussion about how we hung the show, etc., which was terrific. But Smriti Rajgarhia, who's standing over there from the Swaraj Art Archive, and her two young Tagore acolytes, who are also from the Tagore family, have worked really, really hard in putting this whole thing together. So, you know, I think the emphasis on the curator is a little over recorded because people have done a huge amount of work on this in the back. Thank you.
Thank you, Ram. Thank you for appreciating the NGM staff, Ram. But honestly speaking, this wasn't possible without the inspirational words that we heard often from Dr. Godrej and Mr. Khanel. They've been extremely supportive and inspirational for all of us. The show will be or get completed very shortly, but it's time to hear our great Dr. Her contribution towards art is not hidden from anybody from us, from her. She's going to speak a few words about this exhibition and how she's kind of taken and given the support to have this exhibition at the NGMA. I request Dr. Godrej to have a few words.
Thank you, Madam.
connected, and I'm sure the same was with you too. And when you bought the Sunil Janah, it was just your passion and your eye. It was not that, oh, I'm going to exhibit this in the NGMA. There was no doubt about that, I'm sure, in your mind. The second day, and my entire advisory committee, I'm just performing this happy task of inaugurating this exhibition, but I speak on behalf of the entire advisory committee, because there was no doubt when I started my conversation about 1.5 years ago with a young lady who I only met after the show came to Bombay, and I'm referring to Smriti Rajgaria. It was a protracted correspondence with many, many phone calls to the Swaraj Archives, and getting to know her, getting to know the collection, and with the support of everyone here, we said somehow or the other, we have to bring this show to NGMA Bombay, wherever else it may go, to whichever other NGMA, but we need to have it over here. Because I think for the Ministry of Culture and the NGMA to organize exhibitions like this, it's not just a family passion. I think it's a national treasure. And this is the way we have to see it. It records our history. It records the times that India has been through. And my initial knowledge of the Janah collection was through the Bengal famine. I had seen some really, really disturbing pictures that I sort of wonder. And he obviously reflected the same way that here he was as a photographer going around documenting the famine when the people who were there suffering in front of him. It was a tragedy. They were dying all around him. But he recorded that. He recorded this awful, awful part of our history, which is not we read about it in history books, but we actually see it. It should have been a learning experience for the nation, but it wasn't. Because in 1972, that same part of India had a terrible famine after the liberation of Bangladesh. And another very quiet, I know there are many photographers here, but I have to remember because it was a lady who went there and documented this, Mrs. Bhavna Chatterjee, the Dhaka family, and it was as short as the earlier one in the 1920s, 1940s. So I think, when you see when you go on the exhibition, especially to turn around and see the great big poster that's made over there on our great people. And you say, how independently we thought as Indians. We had no taboos. We depicted things as we saw them, no matter what political inclination we had. And I don't think we would see a photograph of the young tribal girl on the front page of any newspaper today. That office would be burned, to put it mildly. So the courage that we had, the fortitude that, the belief that Janah had, and mind you, there are a lot of this developing and experimenting, what I call the Janah finish. It wasn't really finished always, and I believe his wife helped him a lot, putting together his archives. But you're not really going to see that. You're going to see the tribals, you're going to see dancers, you're going to see people of India, professions. So I think he had a huge interest in the medium and what he was doing documenting. And thank you very, very much for sharing your collection with all of us. I assure you about the NGMA footfall. It's not some point that I have made. But when we were appointed, we had a very, very poor statistic. And I'm not going to blow my own trumpet, but or our own trumpet, we are doing fairly well.
just through random accounts, and now even in a digital age, now we have a teeth machine, and we have, of course, the rest of the other things that go with that account, footfall in here. And it's not only the ticket machine, the revenue goes to the government straight away. It's just the activities that we have over here, which are free, and for which there is no charge. So people sort of, I know they sneak in, they don't sneak in, they come in at 5:30 saying, program, and the security let them in, and they do get the opportunity. Or they just whiz up to the fourth floor and then they come down through the steps and see the exhibition. So we do have that sort of footfall. As everybody in Bombay knows, space is a constraint. We're fortunate since the last 15 years to have this new synchronizers open. But every time, as you've experienced all of you who are here the last 7 days, when we mount a show and when we de-mount a show, we have to show across the building. And then it's always an uphill task. No matter how wonderful the exhibition is, to get it back into people's minds, to the public. Yes, we're open for business. With all railway gates open, everybody can walk in. So that is another constraint. I do hope that we will be able to resolve that, either with an expansion wing or a new building. Because as I was mentioning to Mr. Agarwal and Mr. Rahman, we've had so many requests for photography shows. And really the NGMA, it's a recycled building, as you all know, it's a public hall, lends itself to photography. And with the previous exhibition we had earlier this year, it was a very large format book. It also went up to the level that this exhibition goes up to. There were only 38 paintings, images. But it had a different, it had a charm of its own, as indeed this exhibition has. Ram, what can I say? The son, you have the genes. The mother, dancer, the father, an architect. Everybody here knows that. And you have the passion. And thank you for curating this exhibition. I know you have several exhibitions of your own, both solo and group, and awards that you have won, you carry those very lightly on your shoulders, and your monumental work, of course, from the Summit Foundation as well, and the publication that meant for that. So we're really very, very honored to have you here, and when you walk around, you pointed out, I saw that one. And then a little behind you, I said, oh gosh, that's Bina Gandhi. And he said, yes. And he also mentioned that from those long bygone days, there are two people who are still in our midst who belong to the Communist Party of India. I'm only referring to this phase of the exhibition because we're standing at that level. And one is Mrs. Azmi. And and the other is Mrs. Usha Khanna. I do hope that we'll be able to bring these two ladies to this exhibition.
See the show, yeah.
And to see the show. So, Mr. Khanna, I think this is my last.
No, as an advisory. Not last.
No, I'm going to be around for a few more years. But we have put together an exciting calendar of exhibitions which should go through as we keep on reminding ourselves we are an advisory committee. So we have advised the Ministry of Culture and the Director what is our vision for the NGMA till 2017, till April 2017. So we do hope that wishes will be fulfilled. I think they will because we've given it a very balanced approach. And NGMA should go from strength to strength. This 3 years were just the first baby steps.
standing between. We opened the, we formally now opened the inauguration and we have the exhibition open right in front of you. Ram will take a call on taking you all for a curatorial walk for the next